Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being here. My name is Roland Freeman. Well, let me tell you what it is. The Monologue Project. You will be hearing 16 of the 31 monologues that have been submitted. The first iteration to raise awareness about the Monologue Project was held in the to plan events in New York City, Chicago, and LA early next year. Ife Ford, Alexis Cash, let's give them a nice round of applause. Deb Cody, our Pittsburgh regional representative for the drama. Artistic producer of City Theater, and last but certainly not least, Kyle Hayden, take you on a journey. Enjoy the monologue. By Phyllis Cicero. Standing center stage is a thinking woman, sitting in sorts of ways, up dudes, afros, bumpy ponytails, and nothing seems to here with soft, silky, and smooth. She sets it in front of her and stares at it. You hear me? You have become such a small brat. When did you get up the nerve to disrespect me? Sure enough, shifting back into a devastated home. Because all you do is pitch a loud voice to anyone who tries to come near you. Thank you.
comes way up there. You stood stubborn, steadfast against the wind. You blocked it from my face. You are ungrateful with all of the gifts I give to you, all the productions which now stand collected. I sing all kinds of lullabies to you with a shout. Clean you, and how do you repay me? You stand up tall and in my the newlyweds well on camera. On their wedding video. Just got married today. My college ex daddy. Friends snickered and whispered about me as I walked. Thank you. Chick will every day for the first year. He got with the flamboyant rooster. Do you know how much Facebook stalking I have to do to find out about your wedding details? You should have just. While you were falling in love and trusting around fancy neighborhoods. And then three more. Weren't there to comfort me when the world said it's not just black lives that don't matter, but all the non-white, non-heterosexual lives as well as in that of the Walking Dead. She loved that. Yes. You still cheated on me with Marcus and humiliated me in front of the subpar ever after. And you bet not edit any of the
have any black friends? Not to be a racist. I don't really, well, the Cuban food isn't for me. It's for Ryan, the delivery guy. I should really learn his name. I mentioned his eyes are hazel because they are, not because I have kind of a little show, but it was sweet. I'd like to think we share the moment of minoritarian solidarity. But he goes down, and a few minutes later, he comes in his food. He only looks at me to be polite. I saw Alton Sterling on the cover of the New York Post. I distribute every morning, but no one ever talks about it. The insurrectionist in me is bolstered by that. Recite the pre-selected phrases and then keep the difference between shyness and self-sabotage. They thought of me as a cordial appliance. This is a place of business. After but she's literally never home. Black friends in theory. I am black, and the black friend to other people. But it makes me feel like if it all adds up to something more than subway rides between white walls. Papers, Samantha sits opposite the desk, facing the audience.
then she goes, no, you gotta go straight. Guy at the wheel, a woman, maybe his girlfriend or wife in the passenger seat, trying to go left, and there she is. And I hear her tell him again, you know, you can't turn. I can hear the tire screeching. He's like, she told him 3 times he can't. I said, what are you doing? He shouts back, and they're going after each other. And I don't know. It takes one to know one. The lady at the Haitian place. Isn't it an island thing? Five. truly in an existential crisis. Shadows of bone. Tattoos, mohawks, afros, it's nice for me. Sometimes it's nice. It's good for my mental. Recycled into perfection. You can't be alone because your marrow is crudding up somebody else's bones. So, you all right? Now I lay me down to sleep, a chance to dream of my in the mirror and say, that's me. She who sits in a cage of bone with a life sentence. Out of the silence. Because I found it in where
matchmaker. I was keeping my promise to my know what I'm going to look like tomorrow. I could be a mess. By Lisa Ross, character Keisha. In a barber chair, she's putting on a sock. Jasmine stands behind her. The first time I came in here.
You've seen it on Seinfeld and on Frasier, but us BOCs are in full. Let me get a look at your ice cream cone. What you mean, no? Can you get a spoon? Germs to disintegrate after they've been released from their host body. People don't understand that own company. B-O-C Inc. Black neighborhoods, organic markets. No. Down to Tijuana. Got me some of them Mexican antibiotics. Now, I'm making everyone a motorcycle helmet, some scotch tape, garbage bags, and some antibacterial. What do you want to do with this head, Keisha? Oh, just shampoo, please. And remember,
Last Dance by Franz Louis Benson, performed by comedy about returned home to care for her sharp tongue, chain smoking, cane wielding mother.
Good.
Tom Fulton. At least they treated me like I meant so, regardless of what I especially. Even uglier than wives of the NFL, and she ain't even I was real sorry that she woke you up, sweetie.
thing, sweetie. The last thing I wanted was for you to see all this. You know how he was always trying to teach us a lesson, Elisha? You gotta come out where Mama can see you. Mr. Giggles wants you to come out. Mr. Giggles, are you scared? Mr. Giggles, have you seen Elisha? No choice. Daddy can't give us no choice. She never. If you see my baby,
I just did. I don't know why. Everybody was having fun. It's 8:22. You need to get these kids out. Nikki! Down the street, my granddaughter dragged the sky behind her. I looked at my watch. I kept repeating myself.
thy turn to go. Or here, where instead of men, bullets. And watch my granddaughter fall. She was hit. Yanked me. That and he. Lives and dies here. At a vigil. 2 years after Antoine. Today. Today, let's have peace. Up here, it used to be beautiful. Why fear your own neighborhood? Look like the shooters failed. No justice, no peace.
deeper into despair. Start being regular. Holding the sign high above my head. I gotta keep it up. Society is refusing to let my people live. Each lifting of my voice, I can feel my soul try to fix that thing.
He said, no. You just can't show up here. It's like it doesn't matter to me that this bottle of story ends when I go back to the States. This is not the story when I engage in a long-distance relationship while in law school. No! much going on. Yes. You love me all at once. And I would just like to.
Performed by Stormy. If I find myself pushing up against something, resisting, well, I have been accused of being different. Searching for a moment of truth. Afterwards, our director gave life from a second act. Thank God we have 3 more weeks of rehearsal. After a while, my director comes over to me. You are so I just did the first run through of the play we've only been working on. I logged my notes, paying attention to what worked and what didn't work. In time, this thing is going to take wing because I'm a black woman. It bothers me. You're so serious. You don't seem happy. Do I have to be happy? As Sean can be tossing confetti in the air at this point in rehearsal. I'm Sean. Allow me to be serious. And please. I mean. I'm being difficult, I will just simply say, performed by Mandy Green, character.
But Mom and Dad, they're all fine. I mean, she must have seen it all. We don't know. Or it's going to look like a gun. I don't believe he had a gun. I mean, we don't. I glimpsed Mo waving at me from the door. No witness. No one around to make a video. Whenever you hear people saying how awful it all is, think about how many times that must have happened on no camera. I got an A in statistics and probability. No one a video, 1523. All we know is 1523. From here on, I video everything. I know you never like learning.
Tell you a little something. One down the scale for you, right? Your first job. Then, first thing to go, be fat.
Oh.
Detroit and seen my whole neighborhood change over the years. And no ability to even take care of themselves. Stay warm and clean. I ain't saying it was pretty. Like nobody questioning my ability to be able to write. Beautiful, beautiful, very talented, brilliant friend, Gab, Cody, and Seth Powerman. I know you've been watching on Power Round. Thank you guys so much. So, I'm curious to know, how many in the conservatory for the performing arts program. The resources of friends to help him prepare his audition, but I want to talk with you. The monologue project, I was really happy to hear about this. I did not know about it, and it would be very
Sent to you all, you decided and curated what
yes,
you wanted. in the monologues that I did, what I heard was forcing that relationship. Very interesting. Black man, and you're having to work
the simple answer is yes, there is a scarcity. You know that, I know that it won't appear. On lots of levels. There's lack in relationships with parents, lack in relationships with unique to the African American Latino woman of color. So in this particular group, I didn't get a through line of, because I don't ever want to attack my brother. But that is a human condition. That is a reality in our community. That is with us, within us, and exterior without us, that we are left out of. Audition material. And the ability to see them and hear them on a lot. And we have a resource, because as a director myself, I don't want to hear nothing else from the wigs. I don't love it.
But I haven't done a straight play since I was a sophomore in high school. So this was really right there in the middle.
That's why you don't think.
No. And uncomfortable, and we can't always navigate as easily as we thought we might be able to. So that is what I value about this.
Mm-hmm. say all black men are this way. And I was really upset about that because there's a variety. You know, I write a lot of times about situations that I writers, they may have personally experienced some of this in their relationship or otherwise, but some she can do it all, I'm just saying. And so, but she it's not trying, we're trying not to pigeonhole ourselves or the women who need to audition. And it's important to honor, if we just absolutely have to honor the work. We can make a difference. So we can change policy. So we can inject
librarians need to know it. It needs to be in the Dallas library. It has to be available.
Right.
If these kids can't, ladies, young ladies can't get their hands on it,
incorporated more in our fine arts programs and the programs we need to introduce it. Bring all that together so that these young people can be
I was going to also say that, you know, in the vein of it staying put or staying in the audition,
producers in the room, but it is your responsibility to produce a work
right.
Where the
I was beginning to say, there's a lot of work, there's a lot of work out there,
yeah.
Written by women.
Yeah.
I played a movie back in the early 60s in New York, and I remember Leroy Jones, Amir Baraka, told us, we need to get away from the village, we all moved to Newark, New Jersey. We started setting up with my women too. Is to enhance that, to build that more. And now that responsibility of these teaching the history of African American theater. But yet you go and ask any young man, any kid, so those things that we need to go back and institutions like this. And I don't, you know, we were so much into singing and dancing. You know, 10 years ago, you where I think we really need to start.
Well, I haven't gotten active since 2011. About Mr. Ed Smith to the children about the workshop here, and she came to volunteer. I got a chance to be honored. I have you put your wig on. I'll see you before I can help you.